Good morning, students. Today, we are going to discuss about state government. We have discussed yesterday how a person is selected as the chief minister. The chief minister is the leader of the majority party in the government. If majority is not available for one party, two or three parties may join to form the government. That government is called coalition government. So we have discussed this. Majority means simple majority. 50% of the total number of seats plus one. In Karnataka, it is 130. When all the members are there in the house. So, if a person has to remain as a chief minister, majority members in the house should support him. Those who don't support him, they are called opposition party members. So, Karnataka, you know the chief minister is Mr. B.S. Yedurappa, and opposition leader is said to be Siddaramaiah. He is opposition leader. Opposition leader has got equal status like a minister in the government. In central government, there is no opposition because no single party is able to have 10% of the total number of seats. So, no opposition party is accepted or recognized in some government. In the state government, Congress party leader is accepted as the opposition party. This refers to electoral representatives who are not members of the ruling party. Questioning the government, if government does a mistake, they will question the government. So, questioning the government decisions and actions as well as raise new issues for consideration in assembly. If any matter happens anywhere, it is a responsibility of the opposition members also to bring the matter into the mind of the ministers, chief minister and other ministers. So, in the assembly, usually, opposition party will question the government. If government does something wrong, a government is doing something which is not good for the public, they will criticize the government. Usually, the ruling party members will not criticize the government. So, it is the responsibility of the opposition party to criticize the government, because opposition party is the party which is waiting to come to power next time, next election. So it is they wanted to bring out into the public, but expose the ruling party that they are doing mistake. If we are elected to power, we will not do that mistake. So that is the role of the opposition. In every government it is there. And this leader also. If no opposition party is there, the government will do whatever it likes. It will go wrong. So there is necessity to have an opposition party, and good opposition party will help the government to function properly. Very much. In Karnataka, we know the government accepts 121 MLAs are accepted. Okay? Out of that, 119 are from BJP. So, minimum, you know, 119 are required. So, they are having 8 more ministers, 8 more MLAs supporting the ruling party. So, minimum record is 113, they are having 121. Two independent. Independence means those who are elected to the assembly but they are not members of any political party. Without being a member of a political party, they stood as independent candidates and they got elected. So, those independent candidates are two, they are supporting the government. They can say that if you don't support, that is left to them, they are independent. The opposition party include
Father has 67 members,
one independent member,
then 32 JDS members.
So present the strength of the house is
221 only,
because three vacancies are there.
Elections have been taking place, now some elections have been taking place recently. So that is our, this is our total number of members in Karnataka at present. Okay, so that's the opposition. This opposition. Now,
the opposition main role is to question the government. And the day I hold them accountable for the public, this also helps to fix the mistakes of the ruling party. They will expose.
They will show the ruling party is doing mistake. The mistakes which are committed, created by them. So this is their responsibility. It's their duty to do it. That's what they are doing.
The opposition is equally responsible in upholding the just interest of the people.
So the opposition has to work for the people's welfare.
They have to tell the government that you are doing wrong, this step is wrong, this action is wrong, you correct it, rectify. Still the government may do.
But it is a responsibility of the opposition to bring into the mind of the public and to bring into the mind of the government.
Now, how the government like this will come, you know?
What the government does, we will come to know through the press conferences. The chief minister will hold a press conference. And these days, you know, corona cases are there. When the chief minister used to hold public meetings, public conferences. You might have seen with this TV channels will be clear mics in front of the chief, or they may keep it and he will speak. That's they are called press conferences. Official announcement also will be made by the government through press conferences. They will ask, the press members may ask questions and the chief minister may answer. It is not compulsory for him to answer. It is not like in the parliament assembly. In the assembly, chief minister or the ministers cannot say, I will not answer your question. He is bound by the rules and regulations to answer the questions of MLAs of ruling party or opposition. This is the responsibility of a minister in the parliament or assembly.
But when a journalist asks, it is not a compulsion.
If he wishes, he can answer. If he doesn't wish, he need not answer.
But public will watch. Public will see. So in answer to the answer. Some other questions they may not answer. It is left to them to decide. So that's a press conference.
Because after press, the things that are being spoken in press conference will be telecasted in the TVs or the newspapers and all those things. It will be written more in newspaper. Minister has said this.
So press conference is an important method to communicate to the citizens what the government is doing. What the government, anybody can have press conference. So it's not compulsory that ministers can have.
Anybody can have press conference. The analyst should be ready to listen to it. Then only can. So it is a generous response. So you have a right, if you want, you can have a press conference. Generous should be ready. That is all it is. So press conference is a method by the government to give information to the public.
Now we know we have a lockdown. The government is not coming to each home or each village or anywhere, it doesn't announce. It announces for TV and radios.
So the public will come to know the result. So public will watch the news channels, radios are there, televisions are there, then newspapers are there, all this media. All of them will inform us about the governmental decisions. So this is a press conference.
So here, you can read it out, that's only. The officials also sometimes do press conference.
Government members, the officials also to conduct the press conference for the ministry. Officials also can brief the public about the care or steps of what is to be taken. So that is a press conference.
Now, for ministers,
Some of the important leaders of the government are appointed as ministers. Just as we have discussed, only 15% of the total membership can be made ministers. So in Karnataka, around 34 ministers are. So ministers are given departments to take care of it. Okay, so SAS 15, I have written one or two ministers, two or three ministers, the departments. I did not write the details. So here you can see State Department, Chief Minister of the State, which are the department that he is holding. He is responsible. So the departments which he is holding is a Department of Personal Administrative Reforms. Means the officials about concerned. Then Department of Cabinet Affairs, Cabinet meeting, cabinet about other ministers and all those things. That's the cabinet meeting. The meeting of the ministers together is called a cabinet. That's all ministers together is called a cabinet. So that matter is in the cabinet because he is the chief minister. Naturally, he will be responsible for that. Department of Finance. Some states or some chief ministers hold the finance department also themselves. Some may not. So he is the holding finance department. The budget will be announced or budget will be presented to the house by the chief minister in Karnataka. So he is holding the Department of Energy. Department of Intelligence, Home Department means Police Department. Home Department means Police Department. Police Department's Intelligence only is in the hands of the chief minister. All other departments, Home Department is held by another minister. Bangalore Development and Unallocated. Now, Bangalore Development activities are also under control of chief minister. And if any department which are not allotted to any other minister, it will be the responsibility of the chief minister. Because chief minister is a person who allots ministries to the ministers. They take into consideration different regional balances, cultural, age, male, female, everything they take into consideration, caste. How do they take into consideration when they select the ministers? So all those things, all men and old, what should not be young, everybody will be taken. See another department, Govinda Kardwala is public works department is designed. Then we can say Rashman, Department of Transport, this KSRTC is in the hands of Mr. Lakshman Saudi. He is having responsibility of that ministry. So it is his responsibility. I will say some of the, we can see Ashok Narayan is having the Department of Higher Education, Ministry degree and above. Department of Information, Radio and TV is under his control. Technology and Biotechnology, that is his department. Department of Science and Technology, that is also reported by Ashok. Dr. Ashwin, Department of Skill Development and Livelihood, all these things are the responsibilities of Mr. Dr. Ashwin. Like that, so all we have discussed already 4 ministers. There are more 13 ministers more are there, I have not written now. So, like that, every government will have ministers, they are responsible for all the activities taking place in the state, in their department. They are answerable to the questions of the MLAs in the assembly. They are answerable to the public. So these ministers are like that. They are as ministers. So government consists of all this. Then there are officials in the government who are selected through examinations, competitive examinations. So there is a different departments and different sections of the government of Karnataka. Thank you very much.